It simply says that we are given the root of a binary tree and we are given a specific value as an integer, and we are also given a depth. We have to add a row of nodes with this value at the given depth and should follow these conditions. I will summarize it for you. So it simply says that, as you can see, my depth will start off from here. So depth here is 1, depth here is 2, and so on and so forth. So if I go back, it is original. Original tree is this on the left side. So depth is 1, depth is 2, and then depth is 3. Now, out of all these depths, it is said, okay, you have to add a value of 1 at the depth of 2. So at this depth, I should make it shift down and then add a row saying, okay, 1 and 1. As you can see, value of 1 I have added at the depth of 2. But what about the existing values? No worries. Shift all of them how they were originally. Which means, as you can see, this node 2 was in the left of my previous node. So whatsoever I have added in its left itself, you add this node 2. Right, node 6 was on the right of this node 4, which is how, again, I just want to see what is the existence. How was the pattern previously for the node 6? It was on the right of something. So I added a node 1, I will add in the right of that node 1 itself, this node 6. And that's how the entire tree, again, I just have to come up to this point, add this node, and then that's it. My work is done. Same way saying, as you can see, for the next example, if I just write the depth, depth is 1. Depth is 2, depth is 3. I just have to come at the depth of 3 and have to add a value of 1. So I come at the depth of 3, I will add a value of 1. I will simply add a value of, again, I have to just, like, in its space it should come. So I will add a 1 1, and as you can see, 3 was on the left of something, so I added 3 on the left of my current added node. 1 was on the right of something, so I added my new 1 at the right of this specific node. Now, the question for you will be, how will you solve it? Now, I simply ask, what am I actually doing? If I write the exact same graph on the right side, this is the graph for me, right? 1 and 5. What I was actually doing? First thing is, I have to maintain the depth. So again, let's say, I just want to traverse the graph and maintain the depth. We have seen in a bar graph series that traversing the graph is simply, okay, we can simply use either a DFS or a BFS to traverse the graph. Okay, great. Now, while traversing itself, I can maintain the depth, which means I am, again, if I do a standard DFS itself, if I am at this node, okay, my current depth is 1. As I go on to my child, my depth will increase by 1. As I go on to my child, my depth will again increase by 1. So how the simple DFS looks like void DFS, and let's say I have my node. Again, make sure the node structure you have is tree node star of node, right? And then you will have a simple function in which simply you will perform a DFS, and which means, okay, it's a binary tree, so it has only left and right child. So you'll just have a check, okay, if the node is null, you can simply return, else you can simply go and query for your node left, and as in, like, do a call, recursive call for your node left and do a recursive call for your node right. That's it. Now, to just monitor the depth also at every point, you will have to for sure call this DFS from your main function. So you will have to pass in the root in the very beginning. But you also now know that you have to monitor the depth of this entire thing which you are making. So you will do one thing. You will just simply pass in the initial depth. Initial depth of the root is 1. So this represents the current depth. So I can just have a variable here called as int current depth, which will just simply say, at every child as you are going, just increase the current depth by 1. That's it. Current depth increase by 1. That's it. Now, Aryan, everything makes sense. Okay, you monitor the current depth. Now you have the current depth. But the question was not finding the current depth. Current depth you will be given. You have to just stop at that depth and then do some things. Okay, let's do it. So I realize, okay, I can easily, by this function, again, I just, the green part says the modification I did. right? Now, again, this is the blue part is the standard DFS, which we have been doing. Now, we'll just simply modify and see how things can go about. Now, we realize we have to stop at a depth of 2. Okay, at the depth of 2, I have to stop. And then, at this specific depth itself, I have to place a 1. The childs of 4 should be 1.
Oh,
the childs of 4 should be 1, which means I should ideally be stopping not at the depth of 2, but just before him. I will stop ideally at the depth of 1, which means my maksat, my target was a depth of 2. But then I realized I have to actually stop at his parent. He's a father, so he will actually have more power. So I will stop, ideally, I will stop at my depth minus 1. I will stop at this point. Again, my target was a depth, but then I realized my sniper is a bit adjusted. So I, rather than targeting my depth, I have to target my this depth minus 1. Why I'm going in sniper and maksat mode? But yeah, so we realize, okay, we'll stop at this point, which is depth minus 1. And then I have stopped. I know every child in this entire row, which means in this entire depth of minus 1, every child of them will be the new value. Will be the new value, which is this specific one. But I also have to make sure whatsoever child was previously there, that should also be attached. That should also be attached. So what is the new operation I'm doing? I am doing simple two operations. That existing root node, I am just connecting them with the new childs, and the new childs which are made, I am connecting them with the existing. I am connecting them with the existing childs, but in the correct direction. And thus I can simply write back the entire thing again. This will like remain same. I don't have to touch any of the path because tree is already made. I just have to focus on this portion, depth minus 1, and for sure I can just grab the childs of that current node at depth minus 1 and then put those childs back to my new node added. How I will do it, I know. I have realized that this is my default code. This is my default code. In this code, I have to just perform one thing. I have to perform this DFS and everything until I reach my specific depth, which is depth minus 1. So I will say, okay, if my current, again, I'm just trying to show that, okay, what and how we are doing. We realize, okay, we'll simply do DFS until we reach the current depth and until we reach the depth minus 1. So if my current depth, if it is less than my depth minus 1, then I should actually incorporate these two things. Now, but, okay, let's erase this. Again, remember that this is how you will call. If from the main function, you will have to call your DFS root and the value of 1. But then we realize this is okay. This is, but let's say if we have reached the depth, which means if my current depth, if it has become equal to my depth minus 1, which means I have reached my maksat. I have reached my maksat, which means I have reached this node. Then what? Then I have to perform stuff. What stuff? Firstly, get this node itself. So I will firstly get this node, saying, because I need to know now what is the node itself. So I'll get this node. So I'll firstly get this node. But Aryan, this node is already this node, right? Yeah, obviously. If we are at current depth, so this is the node which we have. So we have the node. This node is representing node 4. Provided I am at current depth, which means depth minus 1. But ideally, I would be placing 1s for its child. Left and right child. I will be placing 1s for him. So I should ideally do one thing. Whatsoever child he had existingly, get them out. So I will just say, bro, get the existing child out. Existing left child, I'll get out of my node. This specific node, I will say node. My tablet is itself like this and still I'm writing like this. So it just simply says nodes left. It is existing child. And the same way, I am just making sure that I don't lose my child. I have to kidnap the children, but not, I don't have to kill them. So I will take their address wherever they are doing. Going into very bad. Cool. Existing right child. And I will get the node right. Now, when I have got this, I have to make a new child of the value which is given to me, which is this value. So I will do simply one thing. I will make new child. Say node star new left child will look something as like new, again simple, new tree node star, like tree node, and this value which I will give. This is my new left child I have made. Same way I will make my new right child, and says new right child, and simply saying that new tree node and that specific value. Now I have made my new node, I have my existing nodes, I have my new node. Now simply my nodes left will now be my new node, new left node. So it will be my new left node, new left child. So this nodes left will be my new left node. And for sure, obviously, that node, see, this new left nodes left, new left nodes left will be my existing left node. So new left child, its left will be my existing left child. And the same way I'll perform it for right child, that node right will actually become my new right child. And the same way saying that new right child, its right should actually become existing right child. And thus existing right child. And thus when this portion is done, I know I have completed my aim. This portion of adjustment for one node, again for one node it is done, and it will keep on doing for all the nodes who have a current depth of depth minus one. It will keep on doing for all the nodes. So all the nodes, because it's a DFS call, so it will keep on going, and ultimately I can simply get my stuff done. That is your ultimate code, and you see that how we build this code. Now let's see the code itself. This was the code itself. So if we go and look at the code, firstly I will have a quick check again. There is one thing also mentioned, that if the depth is 1, then what? The depth is 1, which means that you have to place a new node at the top itself. At the top itself, then what you will do? Simply, you will just place the new node here, and then again, let's say, which means that you are placing at the head. But if you are placing at the head, then this root node, where he will come? Left or right? So they are saying, okay, it will come in the left. So I will, if my depth is 1, so I should place it at the top, which means I'll make a new node, and root node will become the left of this new node. That's a case which you can actually handle separately. So I'll do the exact same stuff, that in my main function, if my depth is 1, I will firstly get my current node, which is the root node. I will make a new node of that specific value, and that new node which I have made of this specific value, I will assign my root node to its left. I'll say new node's left is my root node, which is the current node, and then ultimately now my new head is this specific new node which I have made. So I ultimately return my new node. If not, then simply do a DFS by simple saying, bro, root will root, value is the current value, depth is the depth, and this one is the current depth, as I showed you in the recursion. Now my recursion will simply go, and as you can see, we have always our base case that if node is root is null, or if the node is null, simply return. If not, that if my current depth is less than my depth minus one, simply keep on doing your DFS calls. DFS call to node left, DFS call to node right, so on and so forth. Again, depth will increase by one, depth will increase by one. But as soon as your depth becomes equal to your depth minus one, then you know that you have reached the correct depth. So you will get the existing left child, existing right child. Then you will make the new left child and new right child. Then you will connect the nodes left to the new left, and new left to the existing left, and same way nodes right to the new right, and new right to the existing right. And thus you can simply solve it. Now, same as you can see, it's a simple time complexity of O of 1 and also space of O of n and O of n, because of simple DFS. This is for the recursive stack space, and this is for the your O of n call for all the nodes. If still you are eager to do it with a BFS, you can also do it with a BFS, exact same stuff. Instead of using the recursion, we'll use a queue. How we will solve it? Simply, the base case again still remain exactly same. Now, as you know that in a queue, you push the first element in the queue. So I pushed in the root in the queue, and the current depth is in the very beginning 1. Now I will, again, as you remembered, while my current depth is less than my depth minus 1, I should keep on inserting and keep on getting stuff. As soon as my current depth becomes equal, this portion is when my current depth becomes equal to depth minus 1. Rm, but where is that condition written? Where is this condition even written here? It is not written, because if you go back and look, this while loop will run from here to here. And this will run until, like, your current depth is less than your depth minus 1. So it will keep on running. And as it is keep on increasing, so as soon as it gets out of the loop, it will get out only and only when your current depth is actually equal to your depth minus 1. Cool. And what is happening here? As we do a simple BFS, how we do a simple BFS? For a quick recall, let's say if these are the nodes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in the very beginning, I just push in a 1. Now my queue size is 1. So I will empty my queue size until my queue size becomes empty, right? So I will, again, to only use one queue, what I will do, okay, in the very beginning, my queue size is 1. So I will keep on removing the elements from the queue up till the size of 1. Focus on this point. There are multiple ways to implement your BFS, but I always choose this way, that I get the size and then I simply remove, because it simply says this is one level for me. So, okay, I will remove it, and then for 1, the childs are 2 and 3. Right, great. And then I know the next level is of size 2, so I should only remove 2 elements in this level. So 2 is removed, then I will be pushing in 4 and 5, and then 3 is removed, and then I will be pushing null and null. So this way you see that the next level is done. So it's the reason I maintain a size to make sure that how much your queue needs to be done, right? So it gets so the size will be there, and then until my size becomes 0 for that specific portion, it represents that my one level will be done in this entire portion. When I say one level, I will simply extract out the element front of the queue and then simply push in the left and right in the queue, right? Again, you will say, Aryan, why you did not add this condition earlier? Here in this case, you did not add this condition, because it's simple. I have added in the base case itself. If you still want to add the same way, you can modify the same condition by simply saying that here, if my node is equals to null, then simply continue. So you won't have to add this condition, but the same condition you also will have to add here also. Make sure. Again, I'm just showing you how you can implement. There are multiple ways to implement it. Now, coming on back, we saw that we simply have push left and right, and simply at every level, after every level, we are increasing the depth. Now, when we are at my depth minus 1, I will extract out my front, and then exact same code, I copy pasted here, exact same code. And ultimately, I will pass in my, or return in my root. And that's how same time and same space of O of N will be used here also. Same time and space. Cool. Thank you for watching. Goodbye. Take care. Bye-bye. Again, it was a easy question, but a good one.